is a physiological event. And that's when the aircraft has some sort of malfunction, usually in the pressurization or breathing systems, that produces symptoms in the aviator.
We saw a huge rash of PE events in really our T-45 and F-18 aircraft, and they started to increase at a pretty rapid rate. And it was decided that, hey, we need to really get after this and figure out what's going wrong.
The Navy stood up the Physiological Event Action Team, and we've been, for years now, getting after that problem, mitigating and now even preventing physiological events from happening.
The PEAT was established basically to really get the conversation going amongst the important people to get after the effort. So DOD, industry, academia, aerospace medicine, and out of that, you know, we had the RCCA, the Root Cause Corrective Action Teams, and each of them did their own independent studies to try to uncover, you know, the mystery, and looking at the aircraft, but also looking at the human, because again, PEs don't happen to the aircraft, they happen to the human being.
But for folks having symptoms in the aircraft, there wasn't something we could point to immediately and said, if I just fix this, all the problems should go away. And so kind of the thinking of the RCCA team is that this is definitely multifactorial, it's different every day, different every flight, and different for every pilot, and that's the way that we had to approach it.
So physiological event, you have to have symptoms, but you also have a failure in the aircraft. With a physiological episode is you have symptoms, but you can't attribute it to anything in the airplane.
We looked at patient data for about 3 years, and we divided the patients into the type of aircraft malfunction that occurred. Was it breathing gas systems, or was it pressurization systems?
And then we kind of started to figure out, we need to start educating the aviator on, A, how the system works, how it's there to protect them, what it can and can't do, dispel any myths that are out there.
The flight environment is an overall physiologic negative environment. So you have to be in optimum physical shape to endure the flight environment from a breathing standpoint, from a cardiac standpoint, from a cognitive standpoint. So you have to compensate for the negatives in the flight environment, and you have to be a top athlete.
The actions that the aviators can take to make it safer for them to get in the aircraft really kind of come down to a couple of things. So making sure that you're not dehydrated, making sure that you're eating well, that you're in good physical shape, because again, it's a hostile environment. Two is not normalizing deviance. So if there's something on the aircraft that isn't working right, just don't take it and go fly.
We've done a lot of stuff to the aircraft. We've learned a lot. We're doing predictive maintenance now, and we're doing these things all at the prevention of PEs from occurring. And then with the breathing gas side of the house, a lot of it's education.
A high performance, high altitude flight is not something we necessarily do every day, and it's very different than just us walking around or sitting at a desk. So the value of that PE roadshow is being able to explain what those differences are, what the gotchas are, and ultimately restore confidence back to the airframe so that they can go out and deliver capability and not worry about the system taking care of them.
But eventually the whole fleet will be speaking the same language and have a new understanding of, you know, how the systems work, what are being done to the systems to mitigate the PE risk, but also, you know, how do I, as an aviator, interact with those systems in the aerospace environment, and how can I protect myself from, you know, a PE or a physiological episode.
There are a lot of corrective actions that are still out there that need to be worked. So, you know, we can declare victory in the sense that we know what the problems are. Now it's time to do the hard work to go fix those problems.
Still, Naval Aviation is number one safety priority. This is a risky endeavor that we do, but as close to zero as we possibly can is our goal.